Welcome back, guys. Today we're going to take a look at the build our own spot welder. And in this first video, I will go through the basics of building the spot welder out of an MOT transformer. MOT stands for microwave oven transformer. So what you have here is two different types of transformers, or actually the same type but from two different microwave ovens. This one here is something that I built a couple of years ago, and as you can see, I've already prepared it with wires and stuff. That one is also a little bit bigger than this one here. We are going to take this one here and I will show you from scratch on how to build this. As you can see here, we have the main coil on the down part here, and we have a high voltage coil up here. This one here on here we will leave unattended or untouched. Meanwhile, we will replace the upper one with two or three turn coil instead. And the good thing about the microwave oven transformers is the fact that they are split up like this. They are not winded together, and that makes it very, very suitable to build this type of spot welder. You can take your transformer and cut the side here with an angle grinder on both sides and then lift them apart. By doing that, you can insert a coil rather easily into this system here. I'm not going to do that today because I'm going to show you guys how you can do it without using a welder to get this back together again. And either you go and fetch your favorite hacksaw or your favorite snipper. That depends on you. I'm going to use this hacksaw here and hack away and cut this part up. Just be aware of that you will have pieces everywhere when doing this. So it's time to hack away. Just be aware of that you don't hack through the down bottom coil. We now have this transformer all cleaned up, and it's only the main coil left. So I'm going to use this wire I have here. It's 16 square millimeter. It's a little bit too thin for this application, but I did not have any 25 left. So what's important here is to stack it very, very neatly and make sure that you get it very, very tight. I'm going to aim for three turns, and I'm going to start in the middle. Time for the next step. We have this transformer here wind up and ready on this wooden plate that we're going to screw it onto. I'm going to use this kind of SSR relay, and this one is powered from 3 to 32 volt DC, and therefore I'm going to use this small buck converter that converts 230 volt AC to 5 volt DC. And this one will be powering this. With those components, we will be able to turn this on and off in a fast enough rate to actually do the welding. This is also preparation for adding up a little bit more intelligence later on. We'll be right back. The handle is a little bit trickier. I'm going to do the handle out of this wood here, and I'm going to connect the actual spot welding pins with this piece here. The welder is finished. In all its glory, this is a simple spot welder built out of this microwave oven transformer, SSR relay, a 5V DC buck converter, and this micro switch here. The handle is so simple, made of wood, and I have this 2.5mm copper rods here. They can be switched out rather easily because they will wear out. So let's test this out. How this works is just barely that touching this one will engage this SSR relay, and when touching this one the light lets up and it lets current through. So let's see if this actually can spot weld. Firm pressure and tapping it. As you can see, the fuse wire is there. So let's go back and take this rather thick nickel strip instead, and we do the same thing. A copper weld later on, and this is how it looks. It will be sitting very, very firmly. And the good part about this machine is that the longer you keep this down, the bigger weld you will get, and you will easily be able to actually burn those 2.5 square millimeter spotting welds off. So don't push this too long, just shortly. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Today I created a very, very simple spot welder. A spot welder that could be used for your 8650 cells. The spot welder I did today was very simple in terms of it was a very, very manual version. I'm considering to do in the next episode to add an Arduino or some kind of microcontroller that actually controls the time it's on. By doing that, you will get a lot more consistent welds. You can also switch out the handle to a bolt handle, and that will make it a lot easier to work with, because the handle I built today have no springs in it. And with no springs in it, you may get issues with actually having the proper pressure. So once again guys, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, don't forget to press the subscribe button down below, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching, bye!